إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أما بعد فيقول الحق سبحانه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين ثم أما بعد My beloved brothers and sisters I would like to welcome all of you in this house the بيت الله one of the houses of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the day of Friday in this khutbah And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He governed us in this moment, in this time, with ibadah, to listen to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we be together with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Firdaws al-A'la. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and give us the ilm, the knowledge, so we can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More and more. After saying this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our dua, I would like to come today with a reminder from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ahadith, the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about a few points. And I will start with one point before I come to the main topic of khutbah al-jum'ah. It's a tawbah. And I began with the tawbah because without tawbah from the sins, from the dhunub, from the sayyat that we gain and we get daily in our life, this means the amal as-salih is far from the deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ Oh, who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have the khawf, have the khashya of al-Khaliq subhanahu wa ta'ala. And be with the truthful one. And of course, we all know, no one will have the sidq in his life, in his deen, in his mu'amalat, in anywhere, unless if he has iman. Because as-sidq is one of the characteristics, one of the sifat of the Anbiya and al-Mursaleen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مُوسَى إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He qualified Musa that he was one of the Sadiqeen. After saying that at-tawbah, I would like to come to one of the little points, the brotherhood, al-ukhuwwat fi al-Islam. The brotherhood, this characteristic, we miss it the most. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Al-Hujurat, حيث قال, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى, إنما المؤمنون إخوة.
the believers, the mu'mineen, the mu'mineen are brothers. We are the united ummah, the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are together under kalimat tawheed. So I would like to say we don't have to miss this point, because missing not to be brothers, not to be brothers, it will create a tafruqa, the wicked point in the deen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, verily, the brothers, the believers are brothers. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. You make sure the relationship between you and your Muslim brother is the best. Not because what we say, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ and وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because your Muslim brother has right over you as you have rights over him. This is another point about the khutbah today. Let's come to the main topic of this khutbah. المداومه على العمل الصالح شعار المؤمنين. المداومه على العمل الصالح شعار المؤمنين. Maintaining العمل الصالح, maintaining the good deeds, continue to do العمل الصالح. This is how the mu'min, the believer, should be looking like. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in the hadith that he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, as Aisha said, إذا عمل عملا أثبت. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is how he used to be. When he does something as good deed, as عمل, as صالح, أثبت. أثبت means he continued. He continued. He doesn't do it for some time, then he stopped. Example. You see, the Muslims, sometimes they go to masajid, they pray, they do other good deeds for some time. Then suddenly they stop. That is wrong. Because a shaitan ahead of us, the shaitan, the iblis, plus our sin, our soul, is ahead of us. And shaitan plus our self, our soul, our nafs, always whispering not to continue al-amal al-salih. Also, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith which is narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha, حيث قال أحب الأعمال إلى الله أدومها أدومها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves to see His abd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves, I wouldn't say your boss, the father, the wife, the son, the daughter, the king, the prince. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves from His abd to see him continue to do al-a'mal al-salih. You see how beautiful, how great that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now you're sitting in His house, He loves you because He's seen you, you're worshiping Him. I believe nothing greater than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if He loves you. After saying that, after we understood that al-amal al-salih is al-wasila, is the path, is the way for you as a believer, as mu'min, to receive al-hub, the love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is gonna be the benefit, the fruit, the thimar of al-a'mal al-salihah? It's meaning, but I would like to conclude it in a few points. I will come with number one, taharat al-qalb min al-nifaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about that, طهارة القلب من الرفاق means العمل الصالح والذنوب cannot come together. There is no someone his believers, he's a Muslim, and same time he's not Muslims. Either this or that. So al-amal al-salih is the way, is the medicine, is the cure for the nifaq, the hypocrisy. Abu Huraira used to say, al-qalb malikun lil-a'da. This heart, this qalb is a king for the rest of the body. And if the king, which is the heart, is good, everything else, it will be good. The opposite will be, if the qalb, the heart, will not be good, means everything else in the body will not be good. Of course, we love, we want, we wish our heart, our qalb to be fine, to be healthy, to be full of iman. But the only way to have that qalb, the only way to have this type of qalb, al-amal. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned about the qalb in the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله, وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used a word مضغة. You know مضغة? I will give you a little easy example. You know when you cook meat at home, this little piece, you able to carry it in your mouth. This little piece is equal to the size of the heart. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said mudgha means qadr la yundar. So this little piece in the body, which is the heart, ala wa inna fi jasadi mudgha, idha salahat صلح الجسد كله, وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله. This exactly what Abu Huraira explained the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, verily in the heart, I mean in the body, there is a king, there is heart, and this heart, it will be the leader for our body. No, sometimes our heart will push us, will force us to do things, either halal or haram. So the one who has iman, he's gonna make sure always, he's gonna look for al-amal al-salih. Because he remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will love the one who maintain al-amal al-salih. So, طهارة القلب من النفاق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Quran, in Surah Al-Ahzab, قال سبحانه وتعالى, ما جعل الله لرجل من قلبين في جوفه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, the man, he used the word رجل, the man will never have two hearts. You should have one only. So you cannot hide the nifaq example and show the iman, show the ta'ah. Who you gonna deal with? Who you gonna play with? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who said, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows exactly what do you have, what do you do, even secret. I will say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows what do you do, even secret or open. Allah knows it. So there is no other way to hide anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he knows you openly,
He knows your secret. So there is no other way to hide anything you do from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either by mouth, by hand, by ears, by eyes, by feet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in Surah Fussilat, حيث قال يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, a time will come, which is Yawm al-Qiyamah. Your tongue, your lisan, your hand, your feet, it will come either shaheed on you or with you. So make sure, how are we gonna use your lisan? How are we gonna use your hand? How are we gonna use your feet in this dunya before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make our body parts to talk? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه. وبعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في لص آيات سورة الكهف، قال سبحانه فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه، فمن كان يرجو whoever has wish to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the best way he loved, he wants. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. العمل الصالح. This is the only way for you as Muslim to have a good akhirah, to have a good end. And Ibn Kathir, this great Mufassir, he said that whoever live this life in certain way, this how he's gonna be ended. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, he said with the Sahaba, then he told them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves anyone istamala. The Sahaba did not understand what this word istamala. And istamalahu in English means used. When you use something. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves anyone, istamala. So the Sahaba did not understand this term, this word means. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered them, said, يُوَفِّقُهُ بِعَمَلٍ صَالِحٍ ثُمَّ يُقْبِضُهُ عَلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide, will give the hidayah to his abd to do certain good amal, good deeds, then he will continue. He will continue to do this same amal, these deeds, these good deeds, this al-amal al-salih. ثُمَّ يَقْبِضُ يَقْبِضْ رَوْحَ. ثُمَّ when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he will end the life of this abd, he will end it on this al-amal al-salih. After saying that, the second benefit for al-amal al-salih, mahabbatu Allah li'abd. Mahabbat Allah li'abd. It's another benefit. It is something small that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves His servant. It is something really, we don't need it. When you know for sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves you,
I will say, wallahi, if this whole life, this whole dunya, in one side, the other side is with gonna be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will loves you. Of course, this dunya, whatever we have in this dunya, it's nothing equal to حب الله لك. Nothing is gonna be equal to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His abd. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which is Qudsi, al-hadith al-Qudsi, there is hadith Nabawi and hadith Qudsi. The hadith Nabawi is saying the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When I say, قَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ so and so. Al-Hadith Al-Qudsi, it's narrated by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who said it. But either, or I will say, the Quran is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said it. Al-Hadith Al-Qudsi, He said it, but it's not the same. So anyway, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, في سر الحديث which is Qudsi, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Listen to this hadith. الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying, الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying, whoever attacked my عبد in his عبادة, in his ta'a, in his life, I will warn him with a war. So be careful. Do not oppress. Do not put any zul or anyone, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows it. And the zul can be in any way. Zulm could be oppression. Zulm, oppression. Zulm could be in any way. Either by tongue, by eyes, by hand. It depends how the action will take place. Anywhere like that, zulm. I'll give you an example. Why that fight? Is it zulm? Of course, zulm. Lying, coming, the bull, and so like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه. I said about this point is محبة الله للعبد. Allah will loves you when you continue al-a'mal al-salihah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. And nothing more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do the fara'id of this deen, to do the sunan of this deen, to do the mustahabbat of this deen. When you do it, when you continue, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will love you. The third benefit of al-a'mal al-salihah, tafrij al-kurubat wal-masar. Al-a'mal al-salih, al-ta'a, al-ibadah is another way in this life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will fix up this life for us. He will make our life easy. And of course, I didn't have to mention that a lot, because I'm sure every one of us has some issues, right? Has some issues, either job, family, marriage, home, back home, family here, something. That's true, because this is ibtila, test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see how our iman look like, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات. الله سبحانه وتعالى He will test us in our nafs, in our health, in our wealth, in our family, in our kids. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will see, He will be, who will pass this exam and who will fail. And the best to say in any test like that, to say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you say in this type of exam, this type of ikhtilat, ulaik, those who said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, alayhim صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المبتدون. Verily, they will be blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are the most guided one because they understood the point of this life. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Abdullah ibn Abbas is saying, كنت رضيف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على حمار. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and his cousin Abdullah ibn Abbas, both of them, you know, riding donkey. So Abdullah ibn Abbas with رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Allah, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Abdullah ibn Abbas, ألا أعلمك كلمات؟ Shall I teach you words? Then he said to him, احفظ الله يحفظك. He said, احفظ الله يحفظ يا عبد الله. Stay up to the ibadah, the fara'id of this deen, the hudud, the ruling of this deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will love you and He will be pleased you, pleased with you. احفظ الله يحفظك. احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. Stay up to this deen, up to this ta'a, up to this ibadah. Then you will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala تجاهك. What is تجاهك mean? Next to you. He will not leave you alone. إذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. If you seek the help, the hell, do not ask anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, brothers and sisters, how this deen looks like? It is the most easy when you practice, when you do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do. Allah's benefit of al-amal as-salih. So we said, heart of qalb min al-nifaq, cure our heart from the nifaq, tafrij al-kurubat wal-masar. This thing is comes in dunya, but we left dunya now, we're gonna go to the akhirah. Husn al-khatima wal-fawz bil-jannah. Two things you will have it, two things you will have it from al-amal al-salih. One, husn al-khatimah, the good end, the good end, the easy maut, the easy death. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, yub'athu kullu abdin ala man mat alayhi. Yub'ath kullu abd, every abd, every Muslim, everyone who's sitting right now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will take His rawah at the moment of death. Exactly how this life used to go with him. يُبْعَثْ كُلَّ عَبْدٍ عَلَى مَنْ مَاتَ عَلَى. أنظر حديث من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إنما الأعمال بالخواتيم. الأعمال بديدز بعمل إذ بيد خاتمة. Not don't worry about today and tomorrow. Worry about how we're gonna end this life. Worry about if ملك الموت will come. Where is gonna find you? And this is the عدل of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is something about the end. الفوز بالجنة. This is another benefit for العمل الصالح. فيقول سبحانه وتعالى يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying the believers, the mu'mineen who will make the word of the shahada, the word of tawheed firm on them when they reach the moment of death. It means they will die on the tawheed. I will give you example. This is something that happened. Someone, he's one of the good Muslims, the good believers. He spent his life in ta'a, in ibadah, until a day of Friday like today. He wakes up, salat al-fajr, he went home, took shower, he dressed his clothes. Then he walked into the masjid right after. By the door of the masjid, he doesn't want to cross the street to enter the masjid. Another car comes from the other side, hits him. He falls down. They carried him to the hospital. So now, the doctor said his situation is really not well. He's gonna die. After a few minutes, the adhan for Nasi Salah comes in. So, you know, in the land of Arabs, the azan for the salawat always outside the masjid, so anyone can hear it when he passes by. So this man, when he heard the azan of Allahu Akbar, the azan of salah, he raised his hand, saying, La ilaha illallah. Then he left the masjid. He passed away. And this wallahi exactly happened because whoever witnessed that case, they already narrated what they seen front of their eyes. I would say, my beloved brothers and sisters, this how al-amal al-salih will lead us to the good end. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep this iman and this ta'a and this Quran and this sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam firm in our heart. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit ala al-haqq aqdamana. Allahumma ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ashfi amradana وارحم امواتنا وبارك لنا في بيوتنا وارزاقنا واولادنا. اللهم اشف امراضنا. اللهم وحد كلمه المسلمين. اللهم ثبت المسلمين في كل مكان. اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم واتوب الى الله.